Hey friends, welcome back to Acre Homestead. I have my basket here and we are going to be planting our first seeds out in the garden in the ground in 2022. We also are going to be setting up our green stock and we're going to be transplanting a ton of strawberries. I've got all these little baby strawberry plants that need to be transplanted and I thought the green stock would be the perfect solution for that. So let's get into the garden and officially start 2022. I want to show you what just came in the mail, or not the mail, but was delivered yesterday, and that is a whole bunch of wood chips. I get my wood chips for free from getchips.com. It's a free resource that partners gardeners and arborists. My girls have also been having a great time on it. Hopefully it keeps them entertained on here instead of in the garden because we're going to be planting in it today. I also got all these free logs from chipdrop.com as well, or getchipdrop.com. And I was going to burn them for firewood, but some of them are really big and they have cool steps to them. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take them and I'm going to kind of scatter them around my garden and we're going to put pots on. Oh, you okay? That's steep. And we're going to put pots on top of them. So it'll just be kind of a pretty display for all the pots that we're going to have in the garden this year. What we're going to be planting out today is cilantro, a bunch of different snow peas, and sugar snap peas. I also have the fertilizer that I bought through Azure, and we're going to fertilize some of our beds with this. There was one more thing in here I thought, oh, spinach. The last thing we're going to be planting today is spinach. I have a whole bunch of other things that I could be planting today, like potatoes and cabbage and kale, but I don't have that much time because it's going to start raining here pretty soon. It's supposed to rain for 3 days and then we're going to have 5 days of sunshine. So what I really wanted to do was get things like peas in the ground because it helps them to have rain or water of some sort on them right after they're planted. So I can plant all of this stuff today and I'm not gonna have to water anything. And then when it's really sunny out here, what we'll do is we'll come out, we'll plant the potatoes, and we'll also kind of clean up this garden because there's still some things that need to be cleaned up. So the first thing we're gonna do in our garden is we are gonna set up the green stock. This is something I've been talking to you guys about for probably a month now, and today's the day we get to finally set it up. A green stock, even though mine is not green, is a vertical garden, and we are going to stack these on top of each other, and we're going to create extra space in our garden by growing upwards. I went back and forth whether I was going to plant strawberries in here or vegetables, herbs, and flowers, and I could not decide. I could not decide. I could not decide. So finally, I just ordered another one. So the one that we're going to be planting today is going to be 100% strawberries. I have a bed over there. Girls, there's a hawk. Girls, there's a hawk. There's a hawk flying around. That's normally what roosters do, but I don't have a rooster, so I get to tell them that there's a hawk. Go undercover. Good girl. She's watching it. She's paying attention to the hawk. She's looking up. Yep, stay under the tree. This is their favorite tree. This is my fig tree, and I think they like it because it's undercover. Hawks will eat chickens if they have the opportunity. So like I was saying, I have an entire bed over there with strawberry plants, and a ton of the strawberry plants are growing outside of the bed. And I think that because I struggle so much with slugs, I think this might be a good solution for my slug problem, because instead of having to for the slug to only crawl up the side of a raised bed, they're gonna have to crawl up a really tall green stalk. So now we're gonna have two, but the one we're gonna be planting today is going to be the strawberry one. I got the one with the spinny base, and I decided to put it right here, right at the entrance of my garden, so that when strawberries are blooming, I can have a snack right when I get into my garden. Use potting mix in this. Then you stack the next one on top. They go on every other. I'm supposed to put the soil in first before I put this in here, but I forgot, so I'm gonna have to do that now. And the weight of the soil will keep these down. I found this to be incredibly easy to put together. You definitely need to put the soil in the tier before stacking them up, because that weight really does make a difference. So I found it to be the easiest way to do it is to lay out all my tiers and fill them all at one time. And then you can see the light gray circle thing that's on the one that has too high. There are little holes in that, and that is what allows the green stalk to only have to be watered at the top
and it will drip down and it will evenly disperse the water throughout the entire system. This is it right here, and you can kind of see those little holes versus other vertical gardens that you can get. Oh my goodness, it looks like I forgot to put one on there. I'm gonna have to go out in the garden and check to see if I ended up realizing that. I don't think I did. So I'm gonna have to go fix that. But because of those holes, what it does is it allows it to water the entire system.
Can you see just how tall this thing is? I went with this 7-tier and I'm really happy with it. I think this is gonna be super fun. I can't wait till we can start planting in it here in a minute. But this top is where you do the watering and it just goes on like that. So for reference, it took 3.5 bags to fill this up of this potting mix. This is a 1.5 cubic foot bag. This is what I used, and it took 3.5 of these. You want to make sure it says potting soil with some sort of amendment in it. This has worm castings, which is a natural fertilizer. This potting mix came from Amazon, so I can link it down along with the green stock if you're interested in checking it out. You want to make sure you have something really airy that can flow water through it. If you use something like a topsoil or raised bed mix or even native soil to your own, you know, like your own dirt that you have in your garden, that can be too dense and it's not going to let the water flow through the green stock like you need it to. So you want to make sure you follow the guidelines of the manufacturing instructions so that you get the biggest benefit for your green stock. And I cannot wait to go get this filled. So let's go harvest some strawberry plants so we can start planting. I am going to, if we have time before it gets dark though, is I have a half a bag that's still open and I bought a bunch of terracotta pots at the store. So we might pot up some of those pots and we might plant in some of those today as well. This is my strawberry and asparagus bed. You can see these are where the asparagus grew last year. And these leaves are not leaves that I put in here. These are leaves that either blew onto the bed or were from the strawberry plants that died and are just ground cover for themselves. These were all strawberry plants that I either took from my sister's house or that I found around my property and I planted them in here. And you can see these runners. Strawberry plants will shoot out these, what are called runners, and they will create little babies. So this is a baby strawberry plant. This is called a pup from the mother plant. The mother plant is in here. And I have tons of them in here. So I'm gonna go through and we're gonna harvest these together, and these are what we're gonna plant in our green stock. So let's see. I should put my gloves on, but. See, that's the baby plant with all of its roots, and there's another plant. There's actually three plants here. There's one here, here, and here. So we're gonna set these aside, and there's a bunch of other ones over here. They're really easy. They're just surface planted in the ground. So let's go through and harvest all of these. They all came over here because I'm digging up a ton of little bugs for them. So they decided to come hang out with me. So that was very productive. I got not only an entire bowl of strawberry plants, but I cleaned up my walkways, which was on my to-do list anyway, and I see I missed a strawberry plant right here. So I not only got the rows cleaned up, but I just got a free bowl of strawberry plant starts. Now we're going to take our strawberry plants and we are going to plant them. So here is one of our little baby strawberry plants. This is where it grew from its mama plant. These are the roots. And this is the new growth where the plant is going to start growing from. This is a dead leaf that's just going to fall off. Same with this one. You don't want to plant the crown of the strawberry plant, which is where the new plant and the roots meet. You want to make sure you just put the roots in the soil. Some of these strawberry plants only had this much or so of the roots in the soil, and they were doing just fine. You're going to do more damage if you bury them too deep than if you bury them too shallow. I'm going to go through and put one plant in each one of our little holes just to make sure I have enough. And then after I make sure I have enough, I'll go through and I'll select the healthiest looking plants to plant. Each pocket now has a strawberry plant. So I'm going to go through and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to bury each plant. Some of them I kind of stuffed in there as I was putting them in there because I knew that I liked the look of that plant. I still have all of these plants left and I'm going to find something to do with them. But now I'm addicted to this and I want all my strawberries in these. I guess we have to see, the proof is in the pudding, how well they grow. But I'm maximizing my space. Where this green stalk is standing is somewhere where I wouldn't have anything growing. And the fact that it rotates, I'm already in love with that because I was able to work on it and sit in one spot and rotate it as needed.
I didn't realize until after I'd already stacked them up that there is a fill line and it says fill the soil all the way to the tippity top of each tier. And I did not fill it all the way to the top. So I am adding a little bit more soil to each pocket, but it would have been a lot easier if I had just filled it all the way to the top from the get-go.
She is all planted up. I'm going to put a little bit of water in it, but there is one strawberry plant per little section. So that's 46, I think. It's so cute, and I just love how I have it in the corner of my garden, and it is completely flexible. Well, not completely, but I will be able to move this if I decide I want it somewhere else, because each section, I can move each section, even though there is soil in it and, you know, there'll be some weight to it, it'll be light enough to move. So now what we need to do is get planting on some seeds. I want to get some seeds in the ground before this rain hits. I think the first thing we're going to do, because it's not going to take me very long, is we're going to get some spinach in the ground. Let me show you right here where we're going to put it. I'm going to put it right here. This was my Chinese pink garlic, and only one of them right there sprouted. This whole section was garlic. I don't know if it rotted in the ground or what happened, but I figured I might as well get some spinach planted here. I don't want to waste this space. I'm going to take the leaves off and I'll just throw them somewhere. And eventually what will happen is this garlic here will probably get too tall and it'll shade other things out. If I wanted to plant, like, I don't know, a tomato or a pepper, it probably wouldn't work because garlic gets pretty tall. But the spinach, you can usually harvest spinach within 4 weeks, 28 days, 35 days or so. So I can get it planted. We could probably harvest it before this garlic is going to get in the way of the sun for the spinach. And even if it does shade out my spinach, that's okay because spinach does better in cooler climates. Gonna move these leaves over here. Any weeds, I'm gonna pull the weeds up. Go! Nope! Go! Shoot! Shoot! Go! Nope! Hey! Boop! 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 Thank you! I'm all about maximizing my garden space, so it's not always the most uniform and organized. Last year, my goal was I want it very organized. I want neat rows. I want specific beds devoted to specific things. But if you want to do that and you have things like this happen, then you're not maximizing your garden space. And it is better for the plants to be interplanted. When you have monocrops, what that does is, monocrops just means one specific thing in one specific area. Typically, when you think of monocrops, you think of corn, soybeans, wheat fields, things like that, like big agriculture. But even in your own garden, if you have monocrops, if I have one bed right here just of garlic, and say something came and destroyed all my garlic in one area, then I lose everything. And I didn't really think that through when I planted my garlic this year, but by putting other species in it, like spinach, then I'm mixing up that diversity. And I found that, especially with some of the other things we're gonna be planting throughout the year, if I had things in different areas, if say a deer, a bunny, or something came along and ate all of that something in one area, but I had that one thing in multiple areas, then I didn't have to worry about it quite so much. So I haven't even looked up if you should plant spinach next to garlic, but I'm gonna do it anyway because that's what I can plant in the garden right now that is loose, and so we're gonna do it. I have just some different types of spinach here that I've bought through all different companies. If you're interested in where I've bought the majority of my seeds this year, I can link those seed companies down in the description box. We'll do four rows in what's about 1 foot. Maybe we'll plant some here too. I mostly do high intensity planting in my garden. Because I plant in raised beds and my soil is pretty rich in nutrients. And then I just cover them up. I'm loving my seed containers. I'm actually using them. This will keep them protected from moisture. So my chicken is in the bed that I'm going to be planting in next. And I was just thinking, I haven't seen my chickens in those beds in a long time, so it would be safe to plant in them. But, oh well. Come on. Let's go to your sister's.
I kept finding little name tags of what vegetables I had planted in these beds previously. I had some tape from cardboard that I had laid down in the walkways, and the box decomposed, but the tape was still there. So I was just going through and trying to clean anything like that up, and then I went through and was kind of fluffing the soil to prep them for planting what we're going to be planting in these beds next. I was convinced that these chickens were not going to be an issue. But I think I was a little wrong in that. In the fall, if you watched my video where I put these beds to bed, I put a few wheelbarrow full of really composted horse manure in each one of the beds, and then I covered them with leaves that I got from my property and from my neighbor's property. Now to prep to plant the peas that we're going to be planting in this bed, I just take my fingers and I run along two trenches, and these trenches are what we're going to be planting the peas in. I start by prepping two beds with two rows of trenches for my peas, and then I go and I prep the other side of the bed to plant the cilantro in. And these chickens keep scratching up my trenches. The little stinkers. Love them though.
I think it's time to start locking up the chickens, unfortunately, which means I need to get Josh on building a bigger coop for me. All right, we've got our basket here. Oh, off. No, gosh, off, off, off. No. Go. Go, go, no, no. Okay. All right. So I've got Oregon giant snow peas. I have sugar snaps and sugar snaps. And then I have a bunch of different varieties of snow peas that I got from Territorial Seeds that all mature at different times. And I bought way more than I'm going to be able to plant today. Nope, 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 off. Good thing we're doing this before it gets dark here in a minute. So we have little snow peas white, which I'm checking for the chickens, which mature in 30 days, which is absolutely crazy. Little snow peas purple that mature in 50 days. And then we have little snow peas. Oh no, we have sweet horizon, which mature in 60 to 70 days. So I think I'm gonna do, I was planning to plant these two beds with peas, one with sugar snaps and one with snow peas. But now I see I have a lot of snow peas. I might do three beds. Let's start with what I know, which are the sugar snaps. And I guess it just depends on how many seeds I have. I'm going to be doing high intensity planting on these as well. I'm going to be planting every about, I think the typical planting is every 4 inches. So I'm probably going to be doing every two. Let's see what it says. Oh, it says 6 inches. Yeah, I'm not going to be doing 6 inches. I'm going to be doing every seed space 2 inches apart and double row spacing 6 inches apart. Okay. So 2 inches apart makes sense along the way, but I'm going to do two or three rows, and instead of doing 6 inches between the rows, I'm not going to be doing that. I'm going to be doing 2 inches between horizontal and 2 inches between vertical, if that makes sense. These mature in, the sugar snap peas mature in 65 days. I'm excited about these. My favorite about sugar snap peas is just to eat them in the garden. Last year, I did not realize there was a difference between sugar snaps and peas, like shelling peas. So I only planted shelling peas, and I'm like trying to eat these shelling peas that are super fibrous, and just like you get a wad of fiber because you're not supposed to eat the pod part, and they're not my favorite. So I'm excited that we're gonna be doing sugar snap peas so I can snack on them in the garden. My second favorite way to eat them is I get a cast iron scorching hot, and then I put just a little bit of oil in there and I pan sear them really quickly until they've got a good char on them. And then I finish them with a little bit of butter, some garlic, salt and pepper. Oh my gosh, I could eat an entire bowl of them. They're so good. All right, so we're gonna do the sugar snaps over here, kind of right at the beginning of the garden so we can snack on them right when we get into.
In some of the areas, I probably planted them almost maybe only an inch apart or so. A lot of times the seed spacing is determined by planting directly in the ground with not as rich of soil. But my raised beds, I've amended quite a bit and I will fertilize them more. So they, I think, can handle a more intense planting. So my chickens were eating my spinach seeds that I had just planted. And this chicken here, as I'm trying to shoo the chicken out of the spinach, literally is eating the pea seeds that I just planted. So Josh is going to be building a chicken coop pretty quick here. I'm taking the chickens and I'm putting them in the coop. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to go ahead and plant the snow peas in the third bed. So we are now working in the third bed, and we are going to plant two different varieties of snow peas. I've mentioned this before, where the reason I want the same variety, like a snow pea, to have more than one variety that's going to have different maturity dates is so that I can extend my harvest. So I planted the purple ones and the white ones. One is a 30 day and one is going to be a 60 day. And that way I can have snow peas for a longer period of time. The next thing I did was plant some cilantro. And these leaves that are on my bed are eventually all going to be taken off my bed as soon as I start seeing any sprouts. Slugs are my number one issue, and slugs live in mulch, and leaves are mulch. And you might hear a lot of gardeners recommend using mulch to retain moisture. Well, in such a wet climate like I'm in, that is not good advice. So that's where learning your own area, what pests you have, is really important, because the first year I mulched everything and I lost so much to slugs. Last year I didn't mulch anything and it really, really helped because they weren't living in right around my plants. So these are cilantro seeds, and I came up with a new method for planting. Instead of digging a trench and planting in a trench, I went ahead and I just surface sowed my cilantro, and then I took a little excess soil and I just sprinkled it on the top. That made it a lot easier, and I'm probably going to use this method going forward because it saved me a ton of time and trying to do trenches. This is a different variety of cilantro that I'm going to plant in this wine barrel that I have. I'm planting three different varieties of cilantro this year. I'm just curious to see if I can tell a difference. This was one I got from Johnny Seed. The first one I got was from M.I. Gardner, and it was Slow Bolt. And these are the seeds I got from Dollar Tree. So we're going to do three different seed companies, three different seed packs, and we're just going to see if I can tell a difference between the different varieties of cilantro. I haven't had the best of luck with cilantro, but I love cilantro, so we're hoping that this year is our year. These are cattle panels, and I just wanted to double check to make sure that they were going to fit the length of my bed. These are what I'm going to use to trellis the peas, and they did fit. I just don't have the time because it's going to get dark before to trellis these right now or to put T-posts in and get them up. But before the peas start to grow to any size, we are going to get them trellised. The last 2 years, I have not fertilized really much at all, but I'm going to try this year an experiment and I'm going to do a little bit more fertilizing. So I went ahead and I fertilized this entire now spinach and garlic bed, and I'm going to do a little bit more research, but I'm going to probably do some sort of feeding schedule, fertilizing schedule this year. Let's see how it goes. I do want to try to have the most productive garden I can this year. And all you have to do to fill up your green stock is fill it to the line and it will drain and drip into the rest of the stock.
We did it, friends. We got a lot done. I was planning on moving those wood rounds around the garden. I'm going to be, let me show you, putting a few around here and just in different spots. I had this pot and that wine barrel last year, and then I had one little pot here, a terracotta pot, and one little terracotta pot here, and I thought that was really pretty. So I bought quite a few more of these in bigger sizes. I bought some in these size, but some in bigger sizes, and I want to kind of, you know, sprinkle those throughout the garden. But I thought it would be pretty if I had different tiers of them. So if I had a big one on one of those wood rounds and then a little one, and then maybe I get some different color pots, or maybe I put a couple of them next to the wine barrels because I bought a couple more wine barrels. But that's gonna have to wait. We have 4 days of rain. So I'm not gonna actually water in these peas, cilantro, or anything like that. I'm gonna let the rain do it. The rain's gonna take care of it for me. And unfortunately, my chickens, I did catch them eating a couple of the peas I planted, cilantro, and the spinach. So it is time for them now, unfortunately, to be up in their coop. So in the day, I'll put them in this bigger coop, and then at night, they go in their other coop. But now I need to go probably tonight and talk to Josh and seriously start planning, building a bigger run for them, because that's my goal this year on this property, is to build a bigger run for them. All fall and winter, my chickens have free range of my entire 1 acre property, but once things are planted, they're going to eat it and they're going to destroy all the work that I put into it. So then they have to be in their coop. So that is why I want to build them a huge run way back there. So the next plants for the garden are, I'm going to plant the potatoes, and this is why, this is one of their favorite areas to scratch in. There's a big hole they scratched right there. This was very manicured last summer if you watched my tour videos, and so I need to come out here and I need to clean this up, and we need to plant potatoes. It's supposed to be in the high 60s on, I think, Wednesday. So we'll be out here planting potatoes. We're going to start filling pots. I've got a lot of pots we're going to start filling. There's a lot more produce that we can actually plant some starts out here. So we're going to be planting starts. We can plant cabbage and kale and broccoli. Some of them I have already started inside, if you've seen that. Some of them I'm probably going to buy a few. And then I need to go buy a couple more of those cattle panels. And we need to work on trellising our peas. Last year I did not trellis my peas and it was a disaster. I struggled with powdery mildew because they were laying on the ground, getting rained on, getting watered on, and it was a disaster. So it's getting late. It's time for me to go inside and make some dinner. We are having grilled cheese sandwich with tomato soup. I am going to be using the tomatoes we grew in this garden last year. So if you actually, I have a video where I make our tomato soup from the garden and some delicious grilled cheese sandwiches. If you want to watch that, I'll put that up here. If you want to see what I did with 500 and something heads of garlic that are in this bed that I grew last year. I'll put a video on how I preserve garlic and how, to me, 500 and something 50 heads of garlic is not too much for me. So I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. I want to say thank you once again for taking time out of your day to spend time with me. If you're interested in any of the seed companies that I ordered from or your own green stock, I'll link all that down in the description box. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.